pris pour dire je t'aime. C'est le seul qui reste au bout de nos jours. Les vœux que l'on fait, les fleurs que l'on sème, chacun les récolte en soi-même. Au beau jardin du temps qui court, gens du pays, c'est votre tour de vous laisser parler d'amour. Gens du pays, c'est votre tour de vous laisser parler d'amour. Le temps de s'aimer, le jour de le dire, fond comme la neige au doigt du printemps. Fait-on de nos joies, fait-on de nos rires, ses yeux où nos regards se mirent. C'est demain que j'avais 20 ans. Gens du pays, c'est votre tour de vous laisser parler d'amour. Gens du pays, c'est votre tour de vous laisser parler d'amour. Le ruisseau des jours aujourd'hui s'arrête et forme un étang où chacun peut voir comme en un miroir l'amour qu'il reflète pour ces cœurs à qui je souhaite le temps de vivre nos espoirs. Gens du pays, c'est votre tour de vous laisser parler d'amour. Gens du pays, c'est votre tour de vous laisser parler d'amour. Gens du pays, c'est votre tour de vous laisser parler d'amour. Gens du pays, c'est votre tour de vous laisser parler d'amour.
Hello guys and welcome back to this epilogue of Quebec. So that was the national national song ish of Quebec. Now I have I had a request for another song. Now this next song is rather short, maybe 40 seconds or so. It's a folk song ish about the weather in Quebec. Let me just start that. Excuse me for a moment.
Astite crise de tabarnak, astite calice de vierge.
Astite crise de tabarnak, astite calice de vierge.
Astite calvaire, astite ciboué, calice de tabarnak. Astite crise de tabarnak, astite calice de vierge.
Astite crise de tabarnak, astite calice de vierge.
Astite calice de sacrement, ciboué de Saint-Hostie. Astite crise de tabarnak, astite calice de vierge.
Astite crise de tabarnak, astite calice de vierge.
Astite crise de tabarnak,
ainsi calice de vierge.
And that was that. Why did the music still play? God damn it. So, let's start it again. Our let's play is over with Quebec. We'll just let the game run for one tick so things can get updated. So let me just see here. My phone is ringing. I have to wait after this episode. Right, the game run one tick. Oh, still coring. I guess that's good. Oh, convert. Yes. And up until November. Come on. There we go. Right, so let's start by looking at, let's see, the ledger. Sure. Country. Income. We're doing very well. Almost 2,000. Nearly four times as much as Dotsman's. Decent prestige. Very large treasury. We can't really use that much money. Decent amount of manpower. Nearly 500,000. Almost double of Dotsman's again. Development. Roughly double of Dotsman's again. We got all the tech. We didn't get all the ideas, which is a bit of a shame. But we have a lot of stuff to core. And power projection is also quite decent. So, governments. Score comparison? I suppose so. Second place. Oh, damn. Didn't beat Dotsman's. But they had a really good game in this timeline here. We would beat them over time in terms of score here. We were first in everything, in gaining points at least. Score through the ages, nothing in discovery, tiny amount in Reformation, a decent amount in absolutism. but really here in the revolutionary era, we harvested most of our points. Let's go over time, religion. That's fine. Well, I guess Catholic. We are defender of the faith. And Catholicism is the largest faith in the world. I think we helped with that a lot, to be honest. States? Nah. Promise development? Nah. Advisors? Nah. Military leaders? We have anyone good? Yeah. We have the best general in the world. Yeah. 5544. That's really damn good. Blaise de la Bard. Okay. Current rulers? Nah. Emperors? Previous rulers? Who ruled us? We had the de la Tour for a long time. Then the de Blois. And then the Trastamara for a short while. Just 1-4 years. Was that maybe Regency, perhaps? Jean? Maybe. Yeah, probably. Yeah. Because we had a queen here, right? Jean? The first of de Blois? That must be it. Then Louis? The 13th came to power. And then de Blois again. And then at the very end here, Anne de Valois. Valois? Yeah, that was the previous ruler. Army quality. Quebec, we have the highest morale. And then we have not that well or good discipline here. Siege ability. Meh. Not sure where we are. At least not at the top. Defensiveness, not that great either. Professionalism, 60%, that's okay. We have the highest army tradition though, which plays in with our very good morale. So yeah, armies weren't the greatest. Very good morale, but that's it. Rest is mediocre at best. I guess the tradition is very good, but yeah. That's why we have so high morale. Now, total in armies, we have almost 700k troops on the field. And a limit of 804, that's the highest in both regards. We don't have the... No, we do have the highest manpower right now as well. Infantry highest, cavalry highest, artillery highest. Wonderful. Navy? I think we have a decent, yeah, big fleet. They're not very good at fighting, but we do have a lot of them. Certainly the most heavies. Army losses? 3 million, not that bad. Not that bad. All things considered. 10 million to the Ottomans. Naval losses? Income comparison. Taxation, 200 bucks. Production, 800 bucks. Oh, the can is doing well here. Trade, 940, which is pretty good. Tariffs, vassals, Total, almost 2,000, yeah. And, let's see. Charts, mostly Catholicism. Mostly. And yeah, I've been cultivating a lot, so almost fully Francian. Almost everything got cored. We still have a few provinces coring. Yeah, that's cultivating. Yeah. Will they reach... Oh, almost. Not sure. No. If we look at this, we'll finish just before the end. Producing a lot of fur. Technology, cost overview, loans, trade notes. Local. The Caribbean. Producing a lot of the sugar. Let's see, total. Gulf of St. Lawrence, yep. Our home node. Genoa, also doing well. Chesapeake Bay, also control that. Ohio, etc., etc. Trade goods, market share. We should have decent share in a lot of things. Huh. We're sharing this with cotton. With the can, about cotton. With cotton. And other than that, yeah. We have no market share at all in incense, chinaware, or tea. Other than that, we have a small amount in everything, and a large amount in a lot of other stuff. We almost completely control the fur market here, and the tobacco market as well. Damn. Nice. Trade? I don't think our trade is that good. 80. Yeah, it's okay. Mercantilism. Yeah, we didn't max it out this time around. Income? Yeah. We're still making a lot in trade. Coalitions, Costa Spelli, Current Wars, with power, we are number one. Yeah. So that's nice. And that's it. Alright, shall we look at the timeline? Let's do that. Thank you. And that was the timeline for Quebec. So, yeah, we pretty much got the borders I wanted over here in Europe. I would have liked, there was talking, one of you said that I should probably have gotten Wallace as well. Yeah, I guess that would have looked good as well if we got that. We don't have time to get it though, which is a bit of a shame, but it's okay like this. But yeah, getting Wallace would have been nice, I suppose. Yeah, then the borders would have gone like this up here. Yeah, but it still goes like this, just maybe not the perfect way. But pretty damn close. Yeah, so let's see. Let's look at some map modes as well. Trade? No, that's not interesting. The Empire, alright, the Empire collapsed. The AI removed it, amazingly enough. I've never seen that before. At least I don't recall having seen the AI remove the Holy Roman Empire. But kudos to you. Religion? Yeah, we still have some few Protestants. Do they have religious seal? They might, yeah, that's why. Yep, so, but we were, I guess in this timeline, Quebec would have continued converting Europe, probably maybe have released someone over here, reformed Europe, reshaped Europe, but as, of course, Catholics instead, and maybe solidified their holdings on North America, probably tried to integrate the Central Kingdom, but if we had to do it now, it would, well, it won't, it would be done in year 1884, so, yeah, but, yeah. That's how I picture things moving on over here. Probably also Quebec. Maybe staking a claim over here in the Far East. Not sure about Latin America, probably as well. Even though they are mostly Catholics. Maybe, I'm not sure. But yeah, let's see. Tech, no, that's not interesting. It's just green, 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 and a few reds and yellows around. Loot, nah. Culture, though. Now here, we almost culture converted everything in Northern America, North America, almost. We were getting there, and we were starting a bit on the Caribbean as well. And we did culture convert a decent chunk out of Great Britain as well. And yeah, we're pretty much just culture converting everything. I guess we could use the last remaining points just to start something for the lols. To send the timeline, they just continue with our work, our holy work. And we could also maybe use our military points if we can. So we have high development in our mind when we send Quebec on their merry way. There we go. And I guess okay, that's fine. And yeah, we were, let's see, clicking here, all the orange bits, we are actually culture converting them right now. Yeah, here as well, yep, finishing everything, so will all be French or Quebecian, Francian. Anything else? That's trade goods. I suppose we kind of have a gander over here. Mostly furs, some cattle in the Midwest, obviously. A bit of wine in California. Coal, fish, a bit of gold here in Texas. Some corn, or yeah, grain. Bunch of tobacco and cotton. Fur, naval and fish. We never got that bonus to Newfoundland. I think you need to have your capital in Europe for that to trigger. With the fish bonus here, you can get some like +2 goods to each of these provinces regarding fish. But I don't think, did we ever get that? No, we did get Protestants don't eat fish. Huh. Mm. Yeah, but that's the trade map mode. Anything else? Devastation? It's fine. Very green over here. Oh, oof, Russia. You had a hard time here at the very end. Anything else? I don't think so. Great powers, well, it is what it is. Britain's still a great power, huh? Well, I guess they have all their small underlings here and there. She. Yep. No, she's getting subject to... Oh, they're subject, right. Okay. Right, I suppose that's it. I don't recall anything else we need to see. Development, maybe? Hmm. Well, Europe is just Europe. I guess it's a bit more interesting over here. The green valley of Quebec. This is St. Lawrence, right? River St. Lawrence? Yeah. The St. Lawrence River Valley. I'm not sure if it's a valley though, but we'll just say it is. And then we improved a bit here on the coast, and not much though, mainly here in our capital province. Other than that, maybe not that interesting. Okay. 46, damn son. That's a lot. How much is here? 31, not bad either. You are 20. Yeah, we do have some decent ones up here in the New World. Baie Blanche, Nouvelle Angoulême, 16, yeah, 1821. Some decent ones here and there. Yep, I think that's it. So, yeah, if you have enjoyed this Let's Play, please leave a like, comment, subscribe. Right, I guess, next I will not start a new Let's Play, I think, until we've finished the Notch one. So please go and check that one out, if you haven't. I'm sort of not willing or wanting to start a new Let's Play in Europe before the Emperor DLC comes out. I have talked about Wallachia, and Wallachia is relatively high up on my list. But I also think I want to try a Milan Let's Play once Emperor comes out, because they got their new extended tree, mission tree, and they got a new bunch of new events, and they also, well, with the Emperor DLC patch thing coming out, they reintroduced or they added a lot of provinces and changed to this area here in Europe, mainly Germany, Italy. France has also gotten a bit of a makeover, and so has Greece, which is very interesting. Would like to redo a Byzantium Let's Play as well at some point, a proper one. So, but we'll see. Anyways, yeah, thank you much for watching. Please leave a like, comment, subscribe, hit that bell button. I very much appreciate your support, and I hope I will see you in the next one. Au revoir.